Good morning students, we are going to learn algebra and number theory lecture 2 under unit 1 topic is subgroups. Topics to be covered in this video: definition and theorems on subgroups, subgroup examples, group of residue classes modulo n. Course outcome of this video: to introduce the basic notions of subgroups and group of residue classes mod n, which will then use to solve some related problems. Definition of subgroup. Let G be a group. A non-empty subset H of G is said to be a subgroup of G when his H itself is a group under the same operation star of G. So when do you say H is a subgroup of G? When H itself is a group, we say H is a subgroup of G. So H has to satisfy all axioms of group under product. It is obvious E and G under binary operation star are the subgroups of G. Then these two subgroups we call it as trivial subgroups of G, and all other subgroups of G we call it as non-trivial subgroups. It is also known as proper subgroups. Now we will see theorem 1. A non-empty subset H of a group G under binary operation product is a subgroup of G if and only if A into B inverse belong to G for all A comma B belong to H. So here we have to note if and only if. So there are two parts. This is the first part, H is a subgroup of G. Second part is A into B inverse belong to H. So assuming first part, we have to prove second part. Then second part, on assuming, we have to prove H is a subgroup of G. So we will see the first part of the problem. Let H be a subgroup of G. Then H, if it is a subgroup of G, what is the definition? H itself is a group under binary operation star. Now A comma B belong to H means A comma B inverse belong to H, because this is a group, so inverse exists. A comma B inverse belong to H. When any two elements belong to H means its product also belongs to H. So this is a theorem. A into B, A comma B belongs to H means the closure axiom A into B inverse belong to H. So first part is over. Conversely, let H be a non-empty subset of G such that A into B inverse belong to H for all A comma B belong to H. Now assuming this condition, we have to prove H is a subgroup of G. So we have to prove, we have to verify the axioms of group. So since H is a non-empty, there exists an element A belong to H. So by the given condition, we can write if an element belongs to H means you assume this formula, instead of B, I'm going to substitute A. So what I get? A into A inverse belongs to H. A into A inverse is equal to E. So E also belongs to H. So identity exists in H. Next one, we want to check whether inverse exists and also closure axiom is satisfied or not. If X belong to H as an element, then X comma E belong to H. So two elements belong to H means we can write, as per the given condition, E into X inverse belong to H. So therefore, X inverse belong to H. Inverse exists in H for every element in H. So inverse exists here. Then we have to prove closure exists. So A comma B belong to H means A comma B inverse belong to H. Inverse exists already. So applying these two elements in the given condition, we get A into, actually A into B inverse. Instead of B, here we are having B inverse. So substitute, we get A into B belong to H. This is the closure formula under multiplication. So H is closed under binary operation star and hence closure axiom is satisfied. Since H contained in G and associative axiom is also inherited in H, so it is also satisfied. So H is a group now. It satisfies all four axioms of group: closure, associative, identity, inverse. H is a group and hence it is a subgroup of G under binary operation star. Note, if the binary operation of a group G is denoted by plus, then the inverse of A will be minus A instead of A inverse. Now we will see theorem 2. Let S be a non-empty set and P of S denote the power set of S. Verify whether P of S, intersection is a group. Now P of S is nothing but a power set. Binary operation is intersection. We know that power set of P of S is the set of all subsets of S. The binary operation on P of S is intersection. This is given in your problem and we want to verify P of S under a intersection is a group or not. So you take a P of S is equal to G. We verify the axioms of group. Closure property first. We take let A comma B be two subsets of S. So A is one subset of S and B is another subset of S. When you take intersection of two subsets, it is a subset of S. So A comma B belong to P of S means A intersection B also belong to P of S. So P of S is closed under intersection. You can take a P of S as some elements like 0, 1, 2 or 1, 2, 3 and you can check this condition whether it is closed under intersection or not. Next one, associativity. Since intersection is associative in any collection of sets, it is true in P of S. So associative axiom is also satisfied. Next we will find out what is identity. Let A belong to P of S be any element and A is a subset of S. Then A intersection S, actually what is identity formula? A into E is equal to A. Now here instead of product we are having intersection. A into E is equal to the same element A. So A intersection S must be equivalent to A. So which is the identity element here? S is the identity element in P of S under intersection. Now next inverse we want to find out. Let A be any subset of S. S is the identity already we have proved. It is obvious there is no subset B of S such that A intersection B is equal to S. So actually this condition is not satisfied. What is inverse axiom? A into A inverse is equal to E. Instead of product we have to put intersection. A intersection, this is actually A inverse. But this A inverse is not a subset of S. That is denoted as B. It's not a subset of S. That means A intersection B, A in S but B not in S. If you take intersection, you won't get S. You won't get S, you will get only an empty set. So inverse axiom is not satisfied here. So hence P of S, intersection is not a group. Note, P of S, intersection is only a semi-group because it satisfies closure, associative and identity but not inverse. So it is also called monoid. Next we will see theorem 3. Prove that the intersection of two subgroups of a group G is again a subgroup of G. Or if H1 and H2 are subgroups of a group G under binary operation star, prove that H1 intersection H2 is a subgroup of G under binary operation star. We will see the proof. Let what is given H1, H2 are the subgroups of G. Binary operation is star. You take two elements from A comma B belongs to H intersection H2 and we imply this is an intersection between these two. So that means these two elements will contain in H1 and also will contain in H2. So I can write A comma B belongs to H1 and A comma B belongs to H2. Since H1 and H2 are subgroups, by criterion of subgroup, we take A comma B belong to H1 implies this is a subgroup formula by theorem 1. A comma B belong to H1 implies A into B inverse also belong to H1. And A comma B belong to H2 implies A into B inverse belong to H2. Now comparing these two, we can write A comma B belongs to H1 intersection H2 implies A into B inverse belongs to H1 intersection H2. So therefore we proved A into B inverse belong to H1 intersection H2. So hence H intersection H1 intersection H2 is a subgroup of G. Note, it can be in theorem 3 we have taken two subgroups H1 and H2 and we have proved it is a group. Now it can be extended to more than two subgroups. If H1, H2, H3 up to Hn are subgroups of G1, then H1 intersection H2 intersection up to Hn is a subgroup of G. So problem 1. Find all the non-trivial subgroups of Z6, plus 6. We want to find out the non-trivial subgroups. What is a trivial subgroups? As we have seen in the definition, we told you that E and G are the trivial subgroups. Other than that, we call it as non-trivial subgroups. So here you take a Z6, it which will contain 6 elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you take H1 and H2 are the two subgroups of Z6. These two are non-trivial subgroups of Z6 because E is not there and G means all the elements. So these two are non-trivial subgroups. So we will check whether these two are subgroups of Z6 or not by using Cayley table. So this is the Cayley table, H1, 0, Z3, 0, 3, right on the left hand side and right hand side. Then it is under addition 6, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 3, 3, 3 plus 0, 3, 3 plus 3, we get 6, it is modulo 6, so you will get remainder 0. Then it is H2, 0, 2, 4, 0, 2, 4. 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 2, 2, 0 plus 4, 4, and 2 plus 0, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 4, 0, 4 plus 0, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, so value is 0, 4 plus 4, it is 8, 8 divided by 6, you get remainder 2, so I have written 2 here. So just you observe this, these two tables, all the elements contained in the body of this table are is nothing but H1 elements, which is contained in G, and you can check the closure. So any element multiplied with any other element, you are getting some elements which is also contained in G. And since all the body of the elements are contained in G, associative property is also satisfied. Third thing, we want to find out the identity element. What is identity formula under addition? A plus 0 is equal to A. What is 0? 0 is the identity element. So let us take here, 0 plus 0, we get 0. That means 0 is the identity element. 3 plus 0 is equal to 3. That means 0 is the identity element. So identity element also we are able to find. Then you have to check the inverse. So what is inverse? When an element added with inverse, you should get E. What is E here? 0. So A added with inverse, you should get 0. So 0 plus 0, you get 0. That means what is inverse of 0? It is 0. And 3 plus 0, we get 3. So what is the inverse of 3? It is also inverse of 3 plus 3 is equal to 0. So inverse of 3 is 3 and inverse of 0 is 0. Inverse also we are able to find. In a similar way, we can also calculate, we can check all the axioms are satisfied or not for the second table also. Since H1 and H2 are finite subsets of G, H1 and H2 are closed under addition modulo 6. These two are H1 and H2 under addition modulo 6 are subgroups of Z6. Now we will see problem 2. Let H and K are subgroups of G where order of H is equal to 10, order of K equal to 21. Then prove that H intersection K is equal to E. Solution: given order of H is equal to 10, order of K is equal to 21. Since H intersection K is a subgroup of H and K, we can write order of H intersection K divides order of H, order of H intersection K divides order of K. So if order of H intersection K, we take it as R, this formula, these two formulas, we can write it as R divides order of H, R divides order of K. So R divides order of H value is 10 and order of K value is 21. So take the GCD of 10 and 21. It follows it is 1. So R equal to 1. So order of H intersection value. Order means the number of elements in H intersection K is 1 element. So that element will be obviously E. H intersection K is equal to E. Group of residue classes modulo N. Congruence modulo N we are going to find. Let N be a fixed positive integer. Let A and B be integers. We define A congruence B modulo N if A minus B. A minus B is divisible by N. So this is the formula. For example, we take 2 congruent minus 1 mod 3. Minus 1, you bring it to the thing A minus B. This is A and this is B. N is 3. A minus B is equal to 3, is divisible by 3. So 25 congruent 5 mod is divisible by 3. So there is no remainder. 25 congruent 5 mod 2. So when you bring this side and subtract 20 is divisible by 2, your final remainder will be 0. So using the congruence, we will do one problem. Let Z5 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 be the non-zero elements of Z5. Prove that Z5 dot product 5 is an abelian group. Now, the given value Z5 is 1, 2, 3, 4. We form the Cayley table to verify axioms of group. So now, 2 into 2, we get 4. And 2 into 3, we get 6. When you divide by 5, you get remainder 1. Since 6 congruent 1 mod 5, this can be written as 6 congruent to 1 mod 5. And similar way, we can write 3 dot product 5 under 2. When you multiply 6 divisible by 5, we get 1. And 3 into 3, 9 divided by 5, we get remainder 4. So like that, you can find out all the values. Now, look at this table. The Cayley table dot product 5 can be written as 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Multiply all the values. 1 into 1, 1. 1 into 2, 2. 1 into 3 and 1 into 4. So 3 into 3, 9. So the remainder is 4. So it is under dot product 5. So you have to check whether closure satisfies. Look at the body of the table. All the elements are contained in Z5. So Z5 star is closed with respect to dot product 5. Since our body of the elements are in set Z5, either your associative also true. Now we have to check identity element exists or not. One is the identity element. What is the formula of identity? An element multiplied with the identity, we should get that. A multiplied with 1, we should get A, and A belongs to Z5. So here we can take 1 into 1, we get 1. So 1 into 2, 2. So 1 into 3, 3. 1 into 4, 4. So which is the identity element here? 1 is the identity element. Next, we have to find out inverse. From the table, we note that inverse of 1 is 1. And you can see here, inverse of 1 is 1. Because identity element is 1. So you have to check only the 1 values. So here 1. So 3 inverse is 2, because we are getting 3 into 2, we are getting 1. Same way 2 into 3, we get 1. So 2 inverse is 3. And 4 into 4, we get 1. So 4 inverse is 4. So inverse also exists. Further, elements equidistant from the main diagonal. We want to find out commutative axiom is satisfied or not. So what is commutative property? A into B is equal to B into A. So that also you can take it from the Cayley table. And here the diagonally the values are 2, 2. Diagonal values it is existing. So you can also tell commutative property is satisfied. Therefore Z5, dot product 5 is an abelian group. Thank you students. We will work out some more problems during practice session.